William Ranieri there, talking to the residents of Kemptown. I'm now joined by the MP for Brighton, Kemptown, Lloyd Russell Moyle. Nice to see you again, Lloyd. So what would you say to residents that are complaining about drug dealing going on in the area and antisocial behaviour? Because you're actually, obviously, you're MP for the area, but you also live there.
Yeah. I mean, Kemptown, of course, is a lovely place. That's why I chose to live there. And very often I feel slightly... slightly apprehensive even about crossing the border out of Kemptown, because you can find everything you need there. But there is a problem with antisocial behaviour, and particularly with drugs. The problem is not just in Kemptown, it's all over. It is everywhere from the Bristol estate up to Whitehawk, all the way out to Rottingdean. And the problem is that we have reduced support services for people. We have reduced policing for people, and the police commissioner says that you solve crimes by having police investigating behind desks. She's right, but you stop crimes by having police and community police support on the streets.
Which has all but disappeared, it seems.
It has totally disappeared. What's happened is that they have removed the community police officers who had their regular beats, and they now have a rotating group of people that you sometimes will see, but they don't necessarily know the area inside out. They don't know all the people inside out, and fundamentally they're not there on the street. They are reactive, and reactive is not stopping crime.
Okay, tell us about these, because you had a similar situation in Peacehaven and launched an Operation Blitz, which was basically increased police presence, is that right, over weekends?
Yeah, so after a campaign for myself with the local newspapers, we managed to get the police to agree on Thursday, Friday and Saturday nights to have patrol cars, to have direct numbers to the patrol car that the businesses and community would have, to have people walking on the streets. Crime has dropped in 6 months by 30% since Operation Blitz started. Now, Operation Blitz is only a temporary measure, but it shows what you can do when you have people there in the communities, police officers. We now need that in Kemptown. We need it desperately in Kemptown, but we also need to have a joined up approach. And I'm going to go and make sure I speak to the council about jet washing some of those streets, cleaning up the area. And maybe it is time now to start thinking about how we make St. James's Street a real hub of life for people to come to.
Okay, and just going back on your comment about the area in terms of like regeneration of the area, do you think there's enough investment coming in from the council for East Brighton in general and Kemptown?
No, and actually we've been hearing from the leader of the council, Dan Yates, who's just taken over, that we really want to focus on this end of the city now. We need to focus on...
It's neglected, isn't it? Would you say it's been neglected?
Oh, it's been neglected over almost a generation. The arches are crumbling away into the sea. The St. James's Street, the last time Christmas lights were up was probably about 2012, 2013. You have... you have lights and activities happening over on North Street and Western Road, but not over in Kemptown.
It's so central as well, isn't it? It's more or less attached to North Street, and yet it seems like a completely separate community in some ways.
That's lovely. I like that it feels like a completely separate community. I don't want it to just feel like it's part of the North Street drag, but we want to then really develop that sense of community, develop plants, develop people sitting out on the street, develop people actually feeling like it is a place, a destination to go. And that needs some physical planning, but that also needs a real feel of community. And I'm hoping that St. James's Action Group will really come together around some of those things, not just, of course, to complain to the police and the council when they need to do their work, but also let's think of some proactive stuff that we can do. Let's maybe fundraise for some Christmas lights this year. We've got all the infrastructure, all the sockets, by every tree there is a plug socket. So let's use that and let's put fairy lights in all the trees even for the summer.
It sounds like you're sort of vying for a Christmas light switch on gig here, Lloyd. Am I right?
It's not just Christmas lights, but I think that's often indicative of a place that feels proud of itself. But it's not just at Christmas time, it's in the summer. We need to make sure that feels like a place to go. And I think that we can do that, but it needs some investment. It also needs community work. And when we talk about policing, I think we also forget about some of the community engagement that has also gone to the wayside. So those big infrastructure developments are great, only if the community feel involved in them.
I work at the latest music bar, obviously, and for latest TV. There's a lot of love for Kemptown, and we kind of forget that. I know you sort of touched on it, but yeah, like you say, there's different pockets of Brighton and Hove, you know, from the North Lanes to the Lanes to Hove to Brighton to Kemptown, which we really enjoy the variety of the city. Mm-hmm. And that's important to remember as well, isn't it?
It is important to remember, and let's remember there are new bars opening up, even on St James's Street. There's one opened up this week, and you're seeing new businesses coming. You've got some new corner shop opened up that's selling groceries, and these things are really important, and we really celebrate that kind of that diversity. And I honestly, and I don't say this glibly, I honestly could live most of my life never really leaving Kemptown and just enjoying what we've got there, and I want more people to come and join me on that journey.
Okay, on that note, Lloyd, thanks for joining us, and we look forward to you switching on the Christmas lights at Kemptown in December.